And Republicans have already failed on health care.
Is there a way, is there any way that they get together with Democrats and stabilize the markets and give people the proliferation?
Based on what Mitch McConnell is saying about the new agenda starting in 2018, he doesn't really have an interest of making this a priority. He wants to move on to other things like Dodd-Frank reform. He has said that on the record. So I'm not so confident they're going to bring this up. However, I think it's important to address the issue of Democrats touting these enrollment numbers. When the government forces you to buy something or be fined, of course more people are going to sign up for something because they're required by law to do so, or they are punished by the IRS. When it comes to options, rural areas have been completely decimated by Obamacare. Rural hospitals have closed. 7 out of 10 doctors have retired early. And so the only option now is for the free market to come back in with the taking away of the individual mandate, not forcing people to buy something they couldn't afford in the first place, didn't want, and something that isn't actually health care. It's simply expensive health care.
That's a really good point, because in a lot of these areas, there's been forced consolidation, and that's what happens when you have a government monopoly. Mm-hmm. And you don't have a lot of choices in these rural areas, and there's no upside for these doctors, you know, who have community centers.
Leader Mitch McConnell said that he didn't want to readdress or go back to an appeal in 2018. That wasn't necessarily a reflection of the subsidies aspect of this. With my outlook,
he said he didn't want to bring it up as a topic.
He said he didn't want to look at repeal in 2018.
He said he didn't want to bring it up as a priority in terms of what's on the table for the agenda, because he feels like it's a distraction with infrastructure
and repeals.
With infrastructure and Dodd-Frank and all the other things.
Before you get to that part of it, let's look at the reality of what you would have to do. Work with Democrats. Democrats, it doesn't serve them to work with the Republicans on this. You would need 60 votes in some cases outside of reconciliation to do this. You can't get Democrats on tax reform, which is actually for the poor. You can't get them to be honest about Obamacare when over 80% of the people who pay the Obamacare penalty, the tax penalty, make under $50,000 a year. They're not all in the wings of the country. They're in small towns. There are areas where access to care, like 20 counties in Ohio, has been taken away from.
Yeah, but that's absolutely right. And Maria, I think this is something the Democrats need to address. Yeah. And that the more government involvement there is, the fewer choices there are. And as Katie pointed out, that hurts not only low-income people, but people in rural areas who geographically don't have access to care. What is so wrong with free market solutions providing more choices?
Well, as a concept, that's fine, but when we get down to brass tacks of what will happen in the Senate, I agree with Lisa. Mitch McConnell made a promise to Susan Collins. I do think you will, if they bring that forward, they keep the promise, I think you will see Democrats who will support that, because they believe we cannot purposefully do things to tank Obamacare if you're not actually willing to repeal and replace it. That is one place I actually think Democrats, like people like Joe Manchin, Claire McCaskill, others may get on board with, and I hope he keeps his promise to Susan Collins, because she took a chance voting for tax reform based on that promise. He said by the end of the year, that's not going to happen. Let's see how well
he
keeps the promise together.
Let's move on, but as far as Susan Collins, she's not even a Republican. I know you've been
saying that. But now with losing Alabama,
what if they go away if you play Red Roper?
It's a numbers game. It's a numbers game. Republicans need
the leadership. He doesn't
You've lost Alabama. Republicans need every vote. They need Susan Collins. They cannot lose her by breaking this promise.
She's so powerful now. All right, the White House says it will have an outline for an infrastructure plan in just a few weeks. President Trump is going to focus on selling the proposal during his first State of Union address. That's coming up January 30th. Now, unlike tax reform and infrastructure, there will need at least some Democratic support for it to pass. Democratic Congresswoman Debbie Dingell says she's keeping an open mind.